Welcome everybody. This is just a quick first hello. Hey guys, thank you.
Hey.
Thank you all so much for turning up for this Michelle's 30th and our engagement. We've been planning this day for a long time. It's good to see you guys all here and making this day really special for us. It's a particularly special day also because today we're getting married. This is our wedding day today. So Shell and I are going to go inside for about half an hour or so. Get ready.
Okay.
My brother George over there, he's going to be setting up some chairs and some other things. So the minister's arriving in about 15 minutes. So I want you all just to come and take a drink and feel a bit happy. And we'll be back in 30 minutes. Pat, where is she?
She's here.
That's Michelle's ring.
She's in shock.
Pete, where's Pete? Pete, bro. My ring.
Will you give yourself to Doug to be his wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? Now I invite the families to please stand and respond to the question which is in the order of service. And I'd encourage a strong response. Do you, the parents and families of Doug and Michelle, give your blessing to their marriage?
We do.
I think it was about 70%. And there's also an affirmation for the rest of you here. It's the congregation. Would you please follow it? And also responds with enthusiasm. Would you, the friends of Doug and Michelle who have come to share this wedding day, uphold them in their marriage?
We will.
Well, those who want to sit down can now.
The bond between husband and wife isn't spiritualized, as may be thought by many critics of the Judeo-Christian tradition. The Song of Songs expresses pure delight of the woman and the man at their sensuous beauty, their unashamed pleasure in sex, and their deep sense of friendship. No part of the body, it seems, in this book is off limits. The bride describes her husband as a gazelle or a young stag. Who has got a handsome face like the finest gold, great abs, rounded gold, a hard torso like ivory, and strong legs like alabaster columns.
He's arriving soon.
Doesn't sound like anyone we know. He is a man among men. His face, eyes, cheeks, lips and speech are thrilling. And his locks of hair are wavy. But alas, black as a raven. The sex is great, and being with him is to experience the most profound meeting of heart and soul. Well, the bride's sensual virtues are extolled by her husband in even more ecstatic language. She is a mare among the king's chariots, or like a stately palm tree. Her face, cheeks, eyes, teeth, lips, kisses, speech, breasts, thighs and feet are praised in images that, frankly, folks, don't do it for us, but work for them. She likens her breast to two fawns or clusters in a palm tree. Her teeth to a flock of shorn ewes. Her nose to the Tower of Lebanon. Good grief. And her flowing locks of hair, just to complete the hair image, to a flock of goats. Doug and Michelle, do you believe that God has blessed and guided you and now calls you into marriage?
I do.
Doug, would you give yourself to Michelle to be her husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Michelle, will you give yourself to Doug to be his wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?